opening?
Hold on. Sure, I guess.
Alright.
How do I flip my screen?
How do you flip your screen?
You know, I'll just flip my
first
phone.
First off, you take the middle finger, and then you stick it up, and that happens.
See?
It's flipping off your phone. Anyways, oi, hello everybody, welcome back to the Dnd Lunar campaign, where everybody is insane, and somebody drew a dick on Isaac's ogre. I'm sorry.
It's actually a troll, not an ogre. But you know.
Okay.
Well, yes.
This is the, I believe, 10th episode.
Huh? Sorry, I was Harry Potter. I said troll in the dungeon.
No one likes Harry Potter here.
No one, fuck you all.
Except him.
I like Harry Potter.
I think the only people here who have seen it are you and Xavier. The rest of us haven't.
No, I have not watched Harry Potter.
You're not missing much.
I've seen snippets of the gang stabbing a broken wand into an ogre's nose.
Xavier, you're not missing much.
You haven't even seen them.
Keep in mind, that only...
It's not worth it.
Watch it even more. Ah, damn it.
We're doing it for our podcast, so he'll be watching it soon.
That reminds me, I still need to watch that Disney movie, and you need to remind me of what it is.
Me too. It's Ichabod and Mr. Toad.
No wonder I couldn't remember it. That is a wonky, weird name.
It's actually too short. It's like what we've been watching, but it's two different shows. One is
great.
The Legend of Sleepy Hollow, and the other one is Mr. Toad's Wild Ride. I think it's called
Legend of Sleepy Zelda.
Man, who would ever name a movie after me? I'm Mr. Toad!
Freaking.
And I like spaghetti! Oh, I can't do a Toad voice.
Mr. Toad has more of an English accent, if I remember right. It's been a while.
Why would you say that about me?
Saying that's not what he sounds like at all.
Listen, I know I'm a bit of a douche, but that's insulting as hell.
I think that Shrek looks too smooth, Jared.
Didn't make the animation. I just posted it.
He needs a dick on him.
Well, yeah. Good luck finding it.
Let me find.
How else are we going to get illustrations for our Shrek X Shadow the Hedgehog fanfic?
Oh shit!
I'm pretty sure Michael drew the dick on him.
Speaking of Shadow,
that sounds about right.
Speaking of Shadow, did you guys see the new trailer for the Knuckles TV series?
Just don't look. Never ever look up Sonic.
Yes, I saw it.
Just never ever look up Sonic X Shadow because
Yeah.
Mm-mm.
Yes, I saw
the
trailer.
The internet again, huh, son? Finding Rule 34 of the internet again, huh?
Yeah. Cursed things I've seen.
Alright, let's actually start with the campaign, because we have some pacing issues whenever we do these, but whatever. It's good to talk about our lives and about the dicks that somebody drew on somebody's ogre.
The dicks that were lost and found.
Alright, anyways, so, it's been
Maybe
a couple...
the real friend was the... So, along the way.
Okay, so... So it's been a couple weeks, so let me give...
I'm sorry, that was...
I know you can't see me right now, but I'm staring into your soul. Okay, so here's where we left off last time. We were... Basically, Bruno and Taris were recruiting Myrtle to your guys' cause. Doc went to...
Merkel.
Doc went to clean
sure
the kitchen. No, you're fine. And what the frick? Oh. We do a penis joke.
All the more reason to hate goblins.
Right. But don't worry, you are within tens of... a lot of dozens of miles away from the nearest goblin camp. Anyways,
we should be closer. We can't kill them if we're too far away.
Well, keep in mind that, one of your party members doesn't want to fight goblins unless provoked. Anyways, though,
And is that Muddick?
No, that would be Tylenol.
Me.
Alrighty.
Well, Tylenol is worse.
Goblins. I'm tired of seeing it. It's on TikTok.
Keep in mind, Keep in mind, if you have a high enough obsession with killing goblins, what happens when they're all extinct and you kill them all?
I showed
the world would be a better place.
Then we become rich and, you know, just, like, live the rest of our lives with PTSD and keep thinking that the goblins will come after us.
All right.
This is what happens when we kill the goblins.
I finally watch the sunrise on a grateful universe. Goodness gracious. Anyways, though. So before we get into this, I would like to hi Mochi. My sister has a new cat. And your butt is wet and ew. She gets sprayed a few times, so that's probably the case. But,
that's what you hope it is.
Oh, jeez. Okay, anyways. Let me go into detail. Let me, count all your guys' hero points for a second. So,
lost one due to eating the cat, remember.
Okay, Tylenol... Okay, Tylenol canonically did not do that. I'm going to be a lot less lenient from here on out. I'm also going to try and be a bit more hands-off with your characters because they're your characters and how you guys react should be entirely up to you. Of course, the only exception is whenever... your players, you guys are not, like, available. They'll try to, make sure that you guys are here for more of them at once.
And then meet puppet time, yay!
But anyways, though, starting with Vikaruz, because I know that he has the least amount of hero points. Probably based on personality alone.
Fuck you.
For one thing...
Yeah, I can't earn many hero points when you're asleep. We're dead. Okay. We're dying.
So based purely on assumptions, I'm going to give your characters one hero point for every year that you have lived. Based on...
Pew has almost 100.
Okay, so... Because most of you guys have are basically travelers... I'm pretty sure all of you guys are travelers. So, what I've counted is that Vikaruz is responsible for the kill-murdering of two already kill-murdered zombies, as well as one single goblin. That's it. You have 23 hero points, Vikaruz Stoneblaze. And I think I should probably remove 10 of those because of your personality and how you're probably... and probably during those 20 years of your life, you probably did stuff to lose 10 of those hero points. Is that a fair assessment or do you object to this?
I object.
Wait,
my personality should have no bearing on my fighting ability.
Well, this isn't your fighting ability. This is your hero points.
Uh-huh. Anyways, so is that 23 more points or onto my 306?
Your 306? No. This is not experience points, but hero points.
What the hell is a hero point?
It's mostly like
it's how you get to class S. Currently, we're in like class C, C- or something.
Get a trophy wife, Dad. Get a trophy wife, and once you have one, like your life doesn't really change much. Sometimes it becomes easier, sometimes it becomes harder, but it's a nice thing to show off to people. Even though that's a pretty sucky thing to say, I'm sorry. I'm just thinking about how messed up that sounds. A trophy, not a trophy wife. I don't know why I said wife. Especially since I know you can't actually obtain one. But get yourself a trophy. And
I obtained one. I obtained your mother a long time ago. Screw you. That's why you're here.
He could actually say that. Just like, can't obtain one.
You're here because I obtained a one.
Okay, so I'll give you 13 hero points. Because they're basically little trophies.
Where do I put that on my sheet?
You don't.
You could probably put that in like inventory or something. It's mostly just invisible little points.
I'm going to let the Hero Association keep track of my hero points.
That would be me. Anyways.
Alright, I'll let that happen too, because I don't know what I'm doing here with these.
Okay, I'll...
What do you do with these points?
You do with them once I figure out what they're for. But for now, I'm just going to count them. As for you, Tylenol, how many cats have you eaten in your life?
At least 12.
In your 169-year lifespan, Tylenol, how many cats have you eaten?
At least 12.
I'm asking you, Tylenol.
Sorry, he's talking. He just can't hear.
Oh.
His cat. Trying to
Are you trying to eat her too?
We want some Chinese.
No. Oh, geez.
Hey, how's Mochi doing?
She's delicious.
Mochi the Rock?
Okay, so based on, aside from that, She's 169 years old, so that's 169 hero points based on assumption. She has toppled, on my count, I believe, 4 goblins. And I think that's it. And by the way, nobody was responsible for killing Progman, since he kind of harakiri'd. As for you, Taurus, you are responsible for 3 goblins during the campaign, as well as a rogue thief, not killing but incapacitating. So that'll still give you a hero point.
What about the monkey? I chopped the monkey's head off.
Yeah, that also gives you a hero point. And
so that's
25.
I performed a safe a building safety inspection, so it turned out to be not safe. 3 balconies collapsed. So that's a point. Hero points.
Oh yeah, you did drop the balcony, and you actually did get experience points.
Did kill several civilians.
But I did give you... So any hero points that you'd gain, you'd probably lose due to any civilians that you would have... Although I'm not giving or taking away
well, that
anything.
That is entirely...
Because most that of that was unintentional. Accident. Okay, on to... Now, but the real question is, how many cats have you eaten in your lifetime?
At least 12.
None? I thought I have eaten 12. Where
all
did
right.
this come
from? Are you sure that you haven't
could
eaten...
I have possibly...
Have you sure that you haven't eaten your own cat, the elven cat that you've strived to find?
It's got a point. We haven't seen the elven cat.
I literally went into the forest for 5 years to try and find a cure for it. Why would I freaking eat it?
Are you sure you were just trying to find seasoning for it?
No! Was it delicious?
You're just mean.
And this is straight up big mom energy. Oh, that gets into some dark crap. Oh, man. For those of you who have not watched One Piece, at least far enough that you know that Big Mom is a cannibal. Unintentional cannibal, whatever. Anyways,
Cannonball.
Okay. Bruno.
I mean, looking at her body type, she does look like Cannonball.
Hey, you know, did you say how many hero points I have in total?
Okay, you have... Okay, so you're 15 years old, so based on assumption, I gave you 15 hero points, and you got 5 throughout the course of the campaign, so you have 20. And now on to Bruno, so you get 98 based on assumption, and then you are responsible for the death of... 5 goblins throughout the campaign. And I believe that's it. Yeah, I don't. Okay. So now on to the actual introduction, where you guys will introduce yourselves in order of lowest to highest hero points. Starting with you, Father. With 13 hero points.
How many?
13.
Bullshit.
Lol.
This is bullshit. I'm Vicaru's Stoneblaze. And,
did I mention this was bullshit?
Did I? I don't know if I did.
You did.
Yes.
I'm a wizard and deserve respect.
Respect is earned in my line of work.
You also still have a broken arm.
You are a human fighter.
Yeah, and it's still earned.
Yeah, speaking of which, you introduce yourself next. Because you have 20.
He did a lot of work to become a wizard, so he does deserve some respect.
I'm Taurus Willowwood,
That is, in fact, your last name.
Thank you.
It's been a while since I've played, okay? I'm 15, and I'm a human fighter, so, yeah.
Yes. And then Bruno, with 103, introduce yourself next.
Yep, I'm Bruno Riverwood. I'm the guy that keeps these dudes from dying. And I also want to kill spirits.
Alright. And then finally, with 173 hero points, next up is you, Jared. Because you are old.
Right.
Hello, I am Tylenol Acetaminophen, the person who does not eat cats, despite popular belief.
You said...
I am 116...
Your first
I'm 169
instinct.
Years old.
You
I'm 169 years old.
Oh, I caught it.
Your first instinct when a cat was thrown at you from an alley, a dark alley, was to unhinge your jaw and eat it.
That wasn't a canon event.
But why, Jared, was you, your real-life, non-campaign-esque mouth, why did that go straight to eating the cat? When your character loves cats. Specifically based on its backstory, it loves cats.
Yeah.
Explain that to the jury.
It's just a little trolling, Your Honor.
Alrighty, let's actually move on to the actual campaign. It's 20 minutes in. This seems to be a trend. I hope it doesn't continue to be that way. But we didn't completely waste that time. For one thing, let's start... Tylenol's cat after 7 years in the forest. Okay. Anyways, though. So Tylenol and Vicaruz have just felled the two... Goodness gracious. So Tylenol and Vicaruz just got done felling the two... already felled, you know. They're zombies. We already know this.
Yes.
There's nothing else really in that room, so you guys are free to, like, exit the room. And, as you're doing that, Bruno, Taris, and an elf you don't recognize, likely the aforementioned elf that the guy who kicked Vicaruz in the chest earlier, was referring to. And they're kind of talking to each other, all, you know, all jolly and whatnot. And then Myrtle looks at you, Tylenol, and this music plays in his ears.
I can't hear the music.
Oh, wait a minute, that's Colgate. That's a Colgate commercial. Wait, I thought I had premium.
I mean, you gotta have that heavy duty toothpaste to take care of the stains that cat meat leaves on your teeth.
Okay, did you catch that music? The non-Colgate commercial music. Okay, let me try this again and put my phone up against the, Okay, hang on.
Post link in Discord.
That music plays in Myrtle's ears as he sees you. As
yeah,
he sees
I
you,
could
Tylenol.
Catch that.
What?
Just post the link in the Discord, please. Like one strum of something. That's all I heard.
Goodness gracious.
Isn't that one song because I got a feeling?
No.
That's the first note I heard. That...
I looked up Careless Whisper. It was the...
The sax with the sexy sax? That it?
Yes.
I got a feeling is one of the worst songs on this planet.
Anyways.
Are you freaking kidding me?
This is our new rogue. Guys, Tylenol and Vicaruz, this is our new rogue. His name is Dick Cock. Modoc, this is Tylenol, our druid, and Vicaruz, our wizard.
Oh, great.
Oh, alright.
Salutations.
Hello. My name is Myrtle, despite what that guy said. Bruno, right?
Yes, that is indeed my name. My dick.
Stop it. That is not my name. Damn it, it's like I'm escaping one toxic environment into another.
Here, let me actually just edit out of character the, ally sheet, because, gonna need to either update our list of names.
Son of a bitch. Okay. So you guys got a mission of some sort? What are we doing here? Of course he says that with a bit less, you know, stuttering, because that's just kind of how I am. I stutter sometimes.
Yeah. Let me look at my become a thing. Let me just update this quest line real quick. I think we only really have two other quests that we have available to go on currently.
Likely.
With that being said, because this is very clearly a lovely adventure and I do enjoy traveling with y'all, we have two things we can do. We can
either there, buddy, we just met. We just met here. Gotta figure out what the...
Well, we're not counting you, murder.
We have another elf in our party, presumably. Wait, hold up.
An elf who is...
A boy or a girl?
A boy. He is currently...
And he was the guy that played... He was the guy that played the sexy sax in my ear or something?
In his own ear.
Yes.
As he saw... Okay, let me reword this. When he saw you coming out of the building after, you know, killing those zombies... the sexy saxophone music played in his ear as he saw you.
Wow. So, he's dropping a hint of some sort.
I love the... Man, the... Just hearing, like, the realization hit you, it's like, oh! Wait a minute.
Alright, so we've got two places we can go from here. We can either go and try to find my sister, which is what I want to do, or, and I, at this, borrow the trident from our friend, Taurus. We can go to the place, I don't remember what it's called.
What do you mean, borrow? He's in the same party. Everything he owns, you own too.
Yes, I know. I'm borrowing it. Or we can go to the place that this trident's name is from, which is kind of like a side quest thing.
Alright.
Side quest.
Oh, lovely.
Alright. You know, you other guys can type stuff down on the active quest line.
Sure. Well. Let's do that.
Okay.
Going on a trip in our favorite rocket ship.
Do we have any more boats?
Yeah, let's go do the trident thing.
Alright.
Oh my gosh. Guys, please, I want to find my sister.
Maybe she is the one that owns the trident, you know? Yeah. Ever thought of that, big boy?
Fine, we'll go do the trident thing.
I'm sorry, big boy. What?
I really want to find this trident gum.
You already have the trident. Right, so. You're just going to the town where it says on the thing, which is like you obtaining a pencil or something and going like, "Hey, I want to go to Ticonderoga."
Yeah, that'd be fun. Who wouldn't want to go to Ticonderoga?
All right.
So you're heading to Blossom. Okay, so you're heading...
Alright, now, on that note, since we all want to find out where the trident comes from, and we know it comes from Bloxen, does anybody know where Bloxen is?
Oh, yeah, I do. I have a map. Okay, so, go into the world maps... text channel, and you'll see the continent, not the country, that's Alora Valley, and that is, you know, the small country, and I don't think the recording can see the cursor, and either way, you're probably listening to this on Spotify, either way, or not listening to it at all, because this doesn't get any views. See that brown country that is kind of cut into by this other weird pink little turd country?
Why does color matter, bro?
Because we're trying to find the location.
They're color coded for a reason. Because I don't.
I see like other.
Because I don't have names for all of them yet.
I see like.
I don't see any.
I see a lot of count countries. Which one is it?
Okay. So you know where Alora Valley is.
Coordinates on. You have coordinates on this thing. Give me coordinates.
Okay. Like in the. Go to the square with like L5 and 6. You'll see a little brown country that is cut into with by like a pink country. It's adjacent to the big red country in the middle.
Okay. So that is where Bloxend is located.
Yes, that is Bloxend. That is the country of Bloxend.
Wouldn't that be L7 and M7?
I thought Bloxend was a town.
I don't know the name of the town, but I know L7M7. Bloxend is the name
of the... Oh, yeah, X town in the nation of Bloxend.
Yes.
Blocky End area, it's called...
If I worded that differently in a previous episode, then that's what it is now. I'm rewording it.
I just misremembered.
Maybe.
Alright, guys, are you sure you want to... You know, go... Across the continent to this place.
What are we gonna do?
Oh, wait a minute.
Some more goblins.
Which one's on the way?
Yeah, man, it'll be like a road trip.
Yeah, let's get snacks.
Keep in mind, a road trip for you guys with no cars is basically on foot. And by the way, you're just crossing a single country. Although the single country is the country that
we're crossing a single large country the long way.
Some guy on foot. Cross a country. Some guy did cross the entire world on foot, minus oceans, you know. And, well, he did get arrested and jailed for several months for trespassing during a world war. But,
wait, what?
He made it.
Things happen.
The and lore is expanding! Man, somebody better make a wiki of this.
Well, you are an elf, you have sexy feet, so you can cross
the country pretty easily. This happened in the real world, not like...
Wait, you went to jail?
What do you mean, I'm sorry, sexy feet?
Let's get to the bigger issue here.
I'm surprised how long it took her to notice that.
The lore is expanding.
Yes. Alrighty.
It's not the only thing that's expanding.
Exactly, that's exactly what I was thinking, man.
Okay. What about you, Taurus? We haven't heard of...
He's referring to the world map, of course. Not anything else.
Yeah, I'm cool with whatever.
Alrighty.
So you are cool with walking, you know, all the way around...
Dude, I'm fairly certain that he's the most adept to walking, since... Most of the party are mages, and he's the only, like, martial class.
Concerned about my feet.
That is good at walking.
You can walk, surely, right? You're just walking.
Elves are very light on their feet, so they can, you know...
Yes, as he said, elves have very sexy feet. They are very good at walking.
I said nothing of that.
Bruno, are you saying this in character or out?
Considering my parents were killed when I was... right before my balls dropped, I have no idea how babies are made, so, you know.
Fatherless behavior.
Oh, he thinks it's done with feet.
Sometimes it is. But I'm a...
Okay, so... You guys...
I know exactly what he's talking about.
Okay, so if I remember correctly... These blocks, these little squares, pretty much account for 100 miles by 100 miles. Whoa! What the hell? What the bloody frick? Okay, that was weird. Anyways,
so we're about here, which means we gotta travel.
Can we just get, like, horses or something? At, like, a town? Then we wouldn't have to walk as far?
Well, you know...
Alright, so...
Well, you can
based
try.
On my... Based on my quick and scuffed calculations, we have to walk about 600 miles.
Hooray! Let me look at this again, and...
We're gonna have so much fun.
Okay, I elude that. No, these are like 200 by 200 squares. Okay. I remember it now.
Oh yeah, my bad. We're walking 1,200 miles.
Even better.
Don't worry, that little patch in the middle of the country next to you is a lake. Although your characters may or may not know that. I'm sure Bruno and Tylenol might. Taurus probably does not know any of this because he stated that he mostly sticks within the area. But anyways, though, let me let you know of something that your character knows but you probably don't, Bruno. As well as you, Tylenol, because you've also traveled. You're also a world traveler. I think this also applies to Vikaruz, although he's a drunk, so I'm not sure how well he would obtain this, but his stat is intelligence, so let's give this a shot. Okay. So, everywhere that you guys have been so far are the frontiers. The country next to you is also a frontier, but it's in warish shambles.
It's in what?
It's in warish shambles. Lots of towns are in ruins. Lots of places are constantly in renovation by the by many of the northern governments, and many southern countries and northern countries go at war with each other, and this country is constantly in the crossfire.
Okay. Are any of those countries goblins that we can kill?
No.
Maybe.
Stop posting. Oh, goblins.
Okay, where's... Oh, there's my OneNote. I forgot about that. This has all of the information, the libraries. Okay. So, the name of this country is... Okay, it is the Grand Empire of Monzoa. Or just Monzoa for short. That is the name of this country. It is humongous. It is a big-ass country. And it is not safe. So just keep your wits about you. But you do have a rogue on
your team. What was the name of the place again?
The Great Empire of Monzoa.
Is there a town that we could get horses at so we don't have to walk as far?
What if instead of getting horses, we got some sort of magical fantasy creature? Like some really big one. Just one, too.
So good luck finding one, I guess.
People could ride on it at once.
All this is to say...
Like that guy from Avatar, you know what I'm talking about. Avatar the Last Airbender.
All the things I'm saying is to say that you guys are following a town in a country for some specific reason that I don't know. I'm guessing your characters don't know. But you're crossing a war-torn country to get there. I am curious of your motivation.
Let's just... For the side quest, you know, just random side quest, find the name of this town written on the spear that we got from a goblin. And we're going to walk through 1,200 miles of active war zone to get there.
Yeah, because that's actually going to look really good on our resumes.
Or just a YouTube video. Today, I walked through 1,200 miles of active war zone to get to this town. Please like and subscribe.
Lol.
Also, I like how this conflicts with, the last thing that I had in the active quest lines thing for the Try It With Funny Words quest line, is a good place to live, apparently.
Alright, you're gonna spend the rest of your days in Bloxend? An X-Town in Bloxend?
Oh, no, we set up a teleportation system?
You'd probably still have to make the walk. Knowing Terraria logic, at least.
Oh yeah, you'd still have to make the walk and lay down 1,200 miles worth of wiring.
Why don't we just do that along the way?
Do you have wiring?
Well, the real friends...
We have teleporters to...
The real friends is the wiring that we laid down.
Did you find the mechanic in the dungeon? I don't think you guys have been in a dungeon yet.
I don't think we've been in a dungeon yet.
Yeah, we were in the dungeon. We were under the hotel or whatever.
You know what? The thing about it is, I technically don't have any news on my sister, so really there's no way we could even do that quest line, so... let's just go find the Trident, and maybe we'll find news along the way.
Alright. Alrighty. So are you going to explain this to your newly employed rogue? Well, actually, you guys are probably talking about this in character, so you probably are. Alright.
And I do know that I borrowed the Trident from,
from Taris?
Yeah.
So, speaking of which, in response to Taris's, exclamation about, his, question about, stables, well, specifically in Tylenol's, in response to Tylenol's statement about mythical creatures, he says, no. But, in response to Taris's statement about stables, he says, what time is it? Let me look at the time here. That is the, PlayStation sound effect. That does not exist in this world. I still have the notes from the old campaign that we were gonna do with your friends, Ethan. Oh man. That was a long time ago. Anyways. It is, 10:56. And today is, let's see. Today is Sunday. Oh man. If we can get there in time, there's a stable in there and everything, but man, you're gonna love this. This happens every Monday, but like, they gather a bunch of really notorious criminals within the area. And if we get to this place in time, the town is called Mewville. And,
Mewville?
I'm sorry. Yeah.
Mewville? Or did you say Mewville, like as in a cat sound?
Yeah.
M-U-V-I and the rest of it. Goodness gracious. Now what? The memes board.
I don't think you would get it, Nick Xavier.
I don't.
This practice that these people are doing is something that's called mewing. It's when you stick your tongue on the roof of your mouth and as such.
It's an exercise to improve. It's an exercise to improve the definition of your jawline.
Oh.
All right. So we're going to Mewville, and that's. M-U-V-I-L?
Yes. So that's relatively on the way. It's northwest of here, about 100 miles or so. But man, Everybody take one of these badges. He takes out about four of these. He has more, by the looks of it, in one of his coat pockets. But he hands you some, like, police-shaped badges. But they're not... They definitely say something else on it that just says badge. In common, but it says badge. All of this, all you guys, attach that to your left pectoral, and when we get, there...
Ow, it poked my titty.
You want me to put this under my skin?
No, no. I mean on your shirt, on your clothes, of course. Don't actually stab yourself in the... You guys not know how this stuff works.
It was a joke, man.
The pectoralis is a muscle, mind you.
Say the left side of your shirt or something.
You know what, this is...
Just say lapel.
This is still better than working with Doc. Or as you probably would have called him, Cock. But knowing
you... Okay, Doc Cock.
Doc Cock. Anyways, though. So, what do you guys say? Do you guys want...
Dr. Octopus in a different universe.
You want to check out the best show of your lives?
So, why are we going to Mooville, apparently?
Well...
For horses?
Okay.
To get horses?
Well, there are horses there, but more importantly, every other Monday, many notorious criminals within the Aloran and... I need to remind myself out of character here. Corellian areas sometimes gather at this bar, and you won't believe me if you don't see it, but you gotta check this stuff out. Okay, so what are your guys' response to this? Oh, hi, Callie.
So we go to this place, and there's something there that we have to has to be seen to be believed.
Yes, it is. It's cool. It's like I don't know if you've ever seen like a concert or a really cool opera. It's like three times better than that.
Like a really cool Oprah Winfrey.
Oprah is the name of a person.
I mean opera. Opera.
Yeah, it is opera.
I'm sorry.
It's like today's sponsor, Opera GX.
No, I'm sorry. I don't have any sponsors. I'm not that cool. Hello,
Opera GX, sorry.
Hello. We're going to be burying our grandma today. Also, this video is sponsored by Raid Shadow Legends.
Anyway, the next day. Today, I'm Bob the Necromancer. Today, we're doing an unboxing.
Oh, yeah, that reminds me. Vikaru's gained a level last episode. Hi, Mom. Sorry.
Just put your medicine right there.
Okay, drugs. Last episode, Vikaru's actually gained a level, and he did not choose Diviner, as I thought he would. He chose Necromancer.
I mean, look at his PFP.
Okay,
that's the most Necromancer look I've ever seen.
Okay, that's fair. Alrighty. I thought he was a bit of the scholar type, but no, he is a murderous. Anyways.
I wanted to learn new stuff from people who are dead.
Alright,
you learn your history, baby.
Alright, that's fair. That's fair.
Well, the people who are dead don't tell it to you.
Hey, sorry, I know you've been dead for about 1,300 years. Could you tell me how you forded the channel of, ease? Oh, yes, it was quite easy. See?
Alright.
Just be like talking to a corpse. And we're trying to figure out how to ford the channel of D's. And
is it speak to the dead definitely a spell I can eventually use?
It is definitely a spell you can use with necromancy. There's no way speak with dead isn't a necromancy spell.
Yeah. Alrighty, so do you guys agree to what Myrtle is saying? It's about 100 miles, and that'll take you a couple days, I think. What is the travel pace?
And get some animals to
Are there any closer horses you know of, Murder?
Likely. Also, that's not my name.
So there are closer horses.
Yes, yes. About a mile or two, you'll find Pengu Village. But be careful. There's a little girl over there named Arale.
Bringing her into this, huh?
It's my campaign. I can bring in Arale if I want to.
All right, so we have two options for horses. Then we either go to Mooville, where nobody talks because they're all mewing constantly, or we go 1 or 2 miles, and we have to look out for this girl named Arale.
Arale.
It's Corone, I think. Or is it Corone?
No, that's a VTuber.
Ridiculously strong.
No. Sorry, it was Corone. That's the right pronunciation.
To give you a bit of a look into your future if you go to Penguin Village here. She is a gag character, which means she has cartoonishly high strength. In Dragon Ball.
Oh, lovely.
I know exactly who she is.
Oh, I'm not.
I bet you do.
Oh, I know you do.
Let's see. If we have to.
If I wanted to make a Dragon Ball reference, I feel like this would be the perfect character to do so.
Technically, she's not even. I mean, she's in Dragon Ball, but she's from a different comic.
Right, but she is canon to the Dragon Ball universe, and now she's canon to this one, too.
My goodness. What have you done?
Alright, so... what do you mean by watch out for this girl?
She likes to play, and she's ridiculously strong.
Okay, keep in mind, Dad, that Vikarus does not know this.
I'm sorry.
It's good.
Okay, so... Have you ever heard of androids? They're like robots, but they're more humanoid-esque. And this girl is virtually immortal. And
what is a robot?
Oh, yeah. She looks like this, if you look on the memes channel here.
It's like... No, in the 1800s... Like, we're in the 1600s, and then it's like, okay, so, what should we be worried about? Because, you ever heard of Dragon Ball Z? No, this is the 1600s.
So is it canon that Muddick is a weeb?
I mean, anime doesn't exist, but Arale does.
Alright, so, like, how dangerous is this girl? Do we have to be really worried?
Yes. Yes, you do. If you go there,
where's the second closest place to get horses?
Mewville.
Damn, there's just no horses for like 100 miles, huh? Well, all right.
This might be in a valley.
I say we go to Mewville.
Alrighty. Do you want food? Sure. About an hour. Yeah.
Okay, I'll feed you in an hour.
Okay, thank you. Okay.
I'd rather deal with people mewing constantly than, you know, get dead.
says the person who's willing to travel an entire war-torn country to. I love the dichotomy here, just like, you guys literally wanting to, like, follow the name of a town through it, through a war-torn country, but you aren't willing to go to a small little village that has a gag character from Dragon Ball.
Nope.
Like, oh, nope.
She's dragging her balls all the time. We don't want to be there.
Oh,
that's fair. Okay.
You guys saw the meme in the meme sport. No, wait, hold up. Let me edit that.
Let me get this.
Okay, so let's see.
Hast thou ever heard of Dragon Ball Z?
Okay, so you'll have to tell me what the pace of your travel is, because I'm seeing here that normal pace.
Yeah, we've got our new rogue and just like.
Okay. Ever heard of Dragon Ball Z? Okay.
Alright, so...
What have I done?
Excuse me, fine fellow, but this wench we are talking about, what attack patterns does she
have?
Did
you just say wench?
So, ever heard of Dragon Ball Z?
I'm pretty sure that's the lingo they used back then. It was situational.
Okay. Yeah.
This young lass that we are to face.
Yeah, last.
What is her power level? My good fellow, it is over 9,000.
Probably.
Quantity appears to be over 9,000.
Okay, so are you going with fast, normal, or slow pace?
I do apologize.
Actually, this is Dragon Ball. She probably isn't that powerful to use.
She shows up in Dragon Ball Super, Dad.
But she's...
Yeah.
I forgot.
And, that GIF that you sent, is perfectly within reasonable, possibility.
Yeah.
I just know,
so...
Okay, so,
super high back then.
Okay, so... As for... she's as strong as she needs to be for the situation. That's what it means to be a gag character. Anyways, though... Are you guys going at a fast, normal, or slow pace here?
Well... I don't want to wear us out by going too fast, so I say we go at, like, a normal pace.
Okay. Cool. So, in a day, you travel about 24 miles at this pace. So, you should be able to reach this place in about 3.5 days.
All right.
So you guys...
Do you have monkey leftovers, or are we out of those?
Wait, were you carrying that throughout all of this?
I'm pretty sure we kept the monkey leftovers.
Alright, well, you got more rations from that, but, after, you know, another day, you'd probably finish it off. Myrtle would probably be like, what the actual fuck? As in P-H-U-C-C. Fuck.
As in T-H-I-C-C?
Yes. Okay, so you guys are eating monkey after the first day, and he's like, alright, good monkey. You guys sure know how to cook.
Yeah, tasty monkey.
I can't cook to save my life, but yeah. But I gotta ask. Tell me a little about yourselves.
Well, this is my first time cooking monkey. I remember back during the Goblin War of 99, we got attacked by a horde of monkeys.
There was a Goblin War 5 years ago?
And we were also out of food, so we killed and ate them all.
Really?
It was either that or eat goblins, so, you know.
They're not edible. You get food poisoning after, like, smelling goblin. Sire, yes, the power level is over 9 millisimos.
So yes, as you know, I am indeed good at cooking monkey.
Alrighty. What about you guys? He's looking at Tylenol.
How's the war going for you guys? Can't wait to go back home and see my cat.
You like cats?
Yeah, my cat is like my favorite thing in the world.
I think he likes the taste of cat even more than monkey.
Excuse me?
Ooh, pet. Mine too. I love pet cat. How kitty.
Alright. Tell me a little about yourself, Vicaroos.
I don't wanna.
Fair enough. What about you, young man? He looks at Taurus.
Who, me?
Yes.
I mean, what do you want to know?
Well, this is the...
About you.
This is our first campfire together. I just want to get to know you guys. You know, we're going to be traveling together for the foreseeable future.
Okay, I'm the fighter, and,
We should be getting along really well. We're both in the, martial arts, I guess. Although I'm more stealthy, I guess. But you probably hit harder. I guess it depends.
Are you freaking kidding me, Ethan?
Ethan, what the fuck? Are we still on this about cat GIFs? Why does the cat even let him do that?
It was a single joke. You don't need to.
As evidenced by our GIF war last night, I'm a master at locating GIFs.
Oh, man.
Aw,
I'll be back.
Alright. Tara said he will be back. Alright.
Well, tell us about yourself, Murdoch.
Well, my name is, Myrtle.
Hey, Merkle.
Are you aware that calling someone by their not chosen name is really, really rude?
We're conservatives.
I mean, I don't think Squirtle's gonna mind.
You sons of bitches.
Hold on a second, let me just update that in the Allies tab.
Oh, jeez. Oh, no. I love how you guys are pissing off the rogue. The guy who is, likely, you know, really good at sneak attacks.
Well, he's the only one we're paying to be here, so...
Oh, alright. Wait, you're paying me?
We can call him Squirtle if we want to.
We've already gone over this. Yes, we are paying you.
Oh, right. I forgot about that.
You get a cut of the loot.
Alright. I like that. Okay.
I'm sure in light of this, you can tolerate my forgetfulness on your name.
Probably not.
It's a rather hard name for me to remember, you see.
Probably not, but I'll try. as long as you allow me to call you, fuck. I will call you fuck now.
Okay, Squirtle. We have a deal.
Alright, as long as it's mutual. He reaches out his hand to shake yours.
And I, of course, reach out and shake his back.
Cool.
Because I'm polite.
Alrighty. I feel about 10% more comfortable sleeping with you guys now. Especially you.
Raven?
Not you. Not you. You're too white for me.
Wait, what?
You see, if you had a bronze complexion like myself, you would be a lot more approachable.
My God, you'd spend like the coldest days in the undercontinent to get that white. I swear, some people come out of the undercontinent looking like that.
Maybe my half of my, I'm a half elf, so maybe I'm part drow.
Even then, I think they have darker skin usually.
It's like,
yeah, aren't drows supposed to be dark elves?
He's got a point. They are supposed to be dark elves.
Holy crap, we've got a trifecta of elves here. I'm a wood elf. She's a high elf, based on her name. And you're a dark elf.
I didn't say that's what I was. I said I'm a half elf, and I didn't specify what my... I said maybe that's the case.
Hold up, just to clarify, the rogue is an elf, right?
Yes, rogue is an elf. We've gone over this.
An elf who played saxophone music in his ear when he saw you.
Yes, of course.
He also implied that he wants to sleep with your character.
Wait, when did he do?
Just now.
When did he do that?
We're gonna have some little elf babies running around.
Good well, I hope that we get more spider babies. Don't know how to read
implications.
Do you? You're 169 years old. I hope you've managed to
And she has spent most of her time in the woods finding seasoning for her cat. So
it was not seasoning. It was medicinal. Also, who elves cares usually if
seasoning
live?
Is medicinal.
Oi. How long do elves usually live?
Usually around 700 to 800 years.
Right, so that's roughly 1/7 of life. So let's see, average human life expectancy.
It's about... Human life. In this campaign, it's about 70.
Let's see.
Don't half-elves usually live a lot longer, too?
Usually 73,
no, half-elves live about...
75 divided by 7.
Half-elves live roughly a little more than 2 human lives.
That's still, like, twice as long as a human life.
Yeah.
So...
Which is what I was talking about.
Elves live about 700 years. I'm 169. Given that, we're gonna take 700 divided by 7 is 100. And 75 divided by 7 is 10.71, but we're gonna round up to 11. It means roughly 1/7 of an elf life would be 100 years old.
Years.
100 year old elf would be about 11 years of maturity in human terms. So,
well, I'm pretty sure they counted as elves being considered adults at age 100.
Technically, I have the same maturity as a 14 year old. If you look at the numbers,
if we were to compare, you know, proportional ages, you'd be 14.
It's proportional.
But I recall in lore that apparently it's elves get to be 100 and then they're considered adults.
I see. I don't know much about elf.
That's because you spend too much time finding seasoning.
Ethan, maybe I should just take your neck, you know, and roast it over a campfire. We got a campfire right here. Consider that.
However, I do also have experience in neck snapping. And I'm like, oh yeah, I didn't tell you about that Murdoch, did I? And I reach into my pack and pull out the severed goblin head that I ripped off.
I immediately run away, knowing that he could definitely best me in a fight. Because I am an elf and he is not an elf. Where did Xavier and his dad go?
Oh, I'm still here.
You're just silent the whole time.
I was trying. I'm looking for something on my channel thingy.
Oh, I see.
I believe. since we're about to reach a new day. Oh my goodness. I just realized something. I said that this kind of thing only occurs like every Monday. And it's going to take you about 3 days to get there. Well, shit.
Well, we're just there for the horses anyways, so we'll be fine.
Oh, but I wanted to see... these guys getting... Okay. I'll just tell you. Whatever.
Quick question.
What?
Since we're at camp, right?
Yeah.
That means we're able to heal up?
Yes, you're taking a long rest. I mean, that's the assumption, because that's what happens at the end of every day. You kind of just go to sleep.
This is the first time I've camped in this game, so...
Oh, okay. I knew that's how it
works in Baldur's Gate, but, you know, there's some differences between Baldur's Gate and this game, so...
Long rests are pretty similar.
Yeah.
Yeah. I figured, but that's why I'm asking.
Yeah. Okay, so... That also means, Tylenol, you can prepare an extra spell, because, we have not prepared the spell previous day. You can prepare 4 spells, but we only have 3 for you. So, pick a spell from among the, pick your first level spell from among the, druid spell list. I can show you the spells.
I could just Google search druid spell list.
It's a lot harder than you think, because
they're... Edition, okay?
Because the stuff has, like, all right.
I'm looking at the 5th edition. Yeah. A character sheet says 5E, which likely stands for 5th edition.
Correct.
Yeah, it's 5E. We are playing 5E.
This episode isn't going to be a whole lot of action driven, but that's fine, because
so
we've got more of is characterization and making fun of each other, you know, dynamics.
All right, druid spell list. So
except for Tylenol.
Which one would I? Or what level am I?
Your second level. So you can only pick from among the first level spell list.
So I can only pick from my first spells level spells
too, right?
Wait a minute. Oh, I think we already did that earlier, Dad. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, you mean like a preparing? Well.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right now I have Copperhand Languages, Disguise Self, Identify, and Unseen Servant. I definitely want to change some of those.
Okay.
I would like to get rid of Disguise Self.
You're also able to prepare an extra spell since you leveled up.
Okay, good. So I want Mage Armor and Ray of Sickness prepared.
Okay.
And then I'll keep Comprehend Languages, Identify, Unseen Servant, Ray of Sickness and Mage Armor. So now I have those 5 prepared.
Okay.
I forget, was Ray of Sickness a spell or a cantrip?
It is a spell.
Okay, so...
Yeah.
Question, which level do I choose from again? Said first level spells.
Yeah, yes. First level spells. You don't have any second level spells.
Yeah,
you don't get second level spells.
When I leveled up, I got those 2.
Okay.
Okay, not all at once. Second level, all right. And absorb elements, animal friendship, beast bond, charm person. Well, look at that. Create or destroy water. I think I have that one already. Cure wounds, detect magic, detect poison and disease, earth tremor, entangle, aery fire, fog cloud, goodberry, guiding.
Are you looking at the druid spell list?
I got that one. Ice knife, jump, long strider. Yeah, I found one on the internet.
Okay, there. That's probably
good. Purify food and drink, snare, speak with animals, thunder wave, and wild cunning.
Okay, that's you're probably.
Of course, I don't.
Jared, you're probably...
My man's got a spell called Wild Cunning.
You're probably looking...
It's cunning.
Oh my goodness. Jared, you are probably looking at a non-player's handbook version. I will list off the ones from the player's handbook so that everything is fair, because you're probably looking at spells outside of that. You can access Animal Friendship. I think you already have that. No, you do not. Charm Person, Create or Destroy Water, which you do have. Cure Wounds, which you don't have. Detect Magic, Detect Poison and Disease, Entangle, Fairy Fire, Fog Cloud, Good Berry, Healing Word, which you do have. Jump, Long Strider, Purify Food and Drink, Speak with Animals, which you do have, and Thunder Wave.
All right. I think I'm going to do Detect Magic.
Okay.
And if I can choose a second one,
You can't unless you replace one of your already existing prepared spells.
All right. Which ones do I already have?
You have Healing Word, Create or Destroy Water, and Speak with Animals.
I think I'll just do the Detect Magic.
Okay. Alrighty. So now everybody recovers all of their spell slots, HP, and any other uses of their regular abilities. You do not use your wild shape at all this entire day, so you don't need to worry about that.
Question.
What?
When I leveled up, did my spell slots go up at all, or am I still at 3?
You were at 2, but now you have 3 first level spell slots.
So it already went up. Okay.
Yes.
So what I needed to know.
Alrighty. Now on to the next day, which will probably just be a bunch of traveling. You guys can continue to talk to each other as you travel through the woods, up the mountains, and there's it's getting chilly. What?
Nothing.
Okay.
It's at the grandmother's house we go.
Yep. It gets chilly occasionally. Walking, stalking, you find more bears occasionally, but killing them is no difficult task. You
bear meat.
Yeah, get it. You get more. You're able to continue your rations. You find more forests, get lost a couple times. That's all right, because you make it out of there all right. Find some briars. Ouch! I think I got stung by a bee. Oh no!
I have another question.
What?
I know this is how it is on Baldur's Gate, so I'm asking this. Mage armor. If I cast it, does it stay on until the next long rest?
Check the spell. It should tell you the duration.
I'm checking it. Okay. Range, touch, components, VSM. Duration, 8 hours. So the duration is 8 hours, so...
Which is close to long rest, but you got it.
Yeah.
Okay, then I will wait until we're in a battle before I cast it. Because the way I do it in Baldur's Gate, I cast it after
I'm done with it. You just cast it in the morning. Yeah, I know. You do that with all kinds of spells.
Always have it. But if it's only 8 hours, then I should probably wait until we're at least about to do a battle first.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you continue. I think that bee earlier gave you chlamydia. Vikaruz's arm is start. Vikaruz's arm is starting to heal a little bit. It's been 2 days so far, so starting to feel a little bit better.
But yeah, didn't he break his arm or something?
Now, eventually, Myrtle goes up to, Taurus and asks him, so what, do you know, what all do you know about Tylenol? I think she's kind of cute.
I know, like, nothing about her, so.
Ah, man, me too.
We've been traveling together for, like, 10 months, for Pete's sake.
About...
You don't talk at all.
About 5 days, give or take, I think.
Oh, well, I guess the only times I really do talk is when you're asleep or whatever. Get a point. Tylenol does do a lot of talking. Speaking of Tylenol, how's that spider army coming along?
I think it's hot.
They're... I open up my bag and into the millions of spiders, you know, procreating inside. They seem to have practically doubled since the last time. Actually, no, that wouldn't make sense. Spiders have a lot of babies. Hold up.
All right.
Average spider. What about baby the big spiders? Yield. What about the big spiders?
Well, I just.
Of babies. Okay, well, the spiders will lay between 2,000 and 1,000 eggs, so we're gonna say it's is increased by nearly 1,000%.
Well, let's leave this up to the DM to decide.
Well, the spider's still pregnant. It's only been 2 days.
All right. How long did they say this? The two big ass spiders were gonna be pregnant
spider,
for?
Baby incubation time. Was it germination?
What 3 weeks? Okay. Germination is for plants.
What spider? What type of spiders did we decide that it was again?
The two big ass spiders.
What, the hunter spiders.
Yeah, huntsman
spiders. Huntsman spiders.
Huntsman spiders.
Okay. So it's roughly 2 to 3 weeks.
Okay. So you're gonna have to wait a little while. Okay. So So Myrtle goes up to you, Tylenol. You're definitely taller than he is, so he's now noticing this, but he's like he's looking at you and saying, "Hey, what's your favorite color?"
Favorite color is a nice lime green color.
All right. Okay. Are you seeing anybody?
Seeing anybody? I mean, there's like 4 people here right now. I can see them just fine.
Damn it!
Exactly where I would have gone. Bravo.
I ain't blind, you know. Can't believe... Was this your idea of flirting, asking about my eyesight?
I mean... Girls with glasses are cute, so there's that.
Aww. Who did that?
You wild shaped into a cricket.
It's not within the realm of impossibility, I think. Right. Actually, no, crickets can fly, so never mind.
Lightless cricket.
All right, so here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to tell them I appreciate your efforts, and while you are charming, I think we should wait to get to know each other before any deed is done.
I think that's what he's trying to do, Jared.
Yeah, that is the plan, and even,
say I
even though it's difficult to see this, difficult for that, even while I'm seeing all the spiders that are hugging you, procreating, I am patient. I am sorry.
She's okay, my son.
This is the part where you say, "I'm into taller men." I'm sorry.
I mean, she called him son, so.
Alright. Well, anyways, though.
Not as tall as you, I don't think. But yeah, she calls him son, so you know what time it is.
I don't think I know any of your guys' disciplines. I mean, mine is rogue. and his is fighter. But what about you, fuck?
I am a cleric. I am the one that keeps these idiots from dying.
Alright.
Oh, crap!
I'm a necromancer. I'm the one that brings the dying back to life.
You're the late doctor.
Oh, wow, you're that... You guys are that strong? I know that it takes years before... I know that it takes a long, long time before the... A necromantic disciplined ever learns how to actually fully manipulate life and death energy, but man, how strong are you guys?
I'm good enough to keep you from dying. That we'll say that.
Oh. All right. Well, I've been practicing my roguish discipline for a little while now. I'm training to be an assassin eventually. But what about you? He's looking at Tylenol here.
Well, you see, I'm going to be the world's best veterinarian.
I still love the way that you you said that, like, if is this your idea of flirting, just asking me about my eyesight?
That is pretty funny. I plan to go into the healing business, being an elf and whatnot.
Alrighty.
It's a medical business.
When she's locked in her room, imagine what happens the day she gets shut out of the basement. She'll be like, oh my god!
I'm just
helping.
Get down there. Alrighty. So. Oh god, no, what? No. Oh man, I have the perfect thing to do on here. Okay, so, so, another day goes by. You guys go in another sleep. And the next day hits. It is now Tuesday.
I know exactly what could be happening soon.
You guys get stick bugged. Anyways. And then, more and more valley traveling, you reach Carl, the country of Carl. You notice most of it is largely, you know, largely woods and wildernesses.
Wilderness. Yeah. Just wilderness.
The dark... you've noticed, that it's another breezy day, but it's gotten kind of cold as you continue up north. But relatively, it's a decent day. You don't run into any monsters here, but you do get stung by another bee. This is the second time, Tylenol, that you get stung by a bee.
Oh, wait, when was the first time?
Yesterday. Yesterday you got stung by a bee.
Can I use the speak to animal to tell him to frick off or something?
Man, everybody wants to put their stingers in Tylenol.
Anyways, do you want to cast a spell slot to cast speak with animals here?
I'd actually be able to spend that on something better, worthwhile, if you will.
All right.
What am I thinking?
All right. So as you
can I try and cast Guiding Bolt on the bee?
All right.
Not Guiding Bolt. Yeah, why don't Guiding Bolt.
All right, so as you...
Sacred Flame. I'm not going to use a spell slot on this bee.
Okay. So as you start hurling your Sacred Flame at it, you notice that the bee is dead. So you shoot a dead bee with flames.
Ah, sick. Since that's a dex save, that means I'm pretty much guaranteed to hit.
Alright, let's see if this dead bee makes the dexterity saving throw. With a mega disadvantage, I will make it mega disadvantage here. Let's see here. How many d6s can I pull out of this pile? No, I mean d20s. How many d20s can I pull out of this? That's 1, 2, 3. let's see, 4. I swear there's another, there should be, oh, 5. There we go. Let's see, let's see. Oh, wow, 12. Does, I'd say minus 50. So that's negative 38. Does that, does the dead bee dodge your, does the dead bee dodge your sacred flame?
Even with the 12, my spell save DC is 13, lol.
Alright, so negative 38 is, well and truly a failure. And it takes, well, it's 1D8 dead. It's dead. So it's
1d8 radiant damage.
So
4
basically,
radiant damage.
It's extra ultra strength dead. But I don't know. You and everybody else gets 1 experience point. No, you get 1/2 of a experience point because it stung you. So everybody gets half of an experience point.
All right. Let me just real quick add that to my total.
Alright, so let me just put 0.5 in front of everybody's experience point total. What the frick, man?
Nah. Us getting experience this game.
Man, we just watched that that movie pretty recently. I mean, I think it's a stretch calling it a movie.
Short film. Why is he cutting it with like a pirate style cutlass thing?
Yar!
He got that yar har fiddly fiddly.
Okay. So another day goes by, and you have traveled 3 days, along with Myrtle. You get to know him relatively well. You guys, do you guys talk to each other at all?
Yeah, on occasion, except for maybe Taurus, because he doesn't talk much. He doing the brooding human fighter thing.
Alrighty.
No, it's just, I'm a man of little words, or few words.
Well, now it is Wednesday, my dudes. So you end up in Mewville. And, as expected, there is a stable.
There are horses inside?
Finally.
Yes, there are plenty of horses. Horses of separate races, too. It is Wednesday, my dudes. Oh, that is seizure-inducing.
Horses of separate races.
Yes, one of them is a hulking colossal of a horse.
Hey, Xavier-inducing.
Excuse me?
Did you say Xavier-inducing?
No! One of them is huge. Anyways, So one of them is a stallion. One of them. What? How much protein? Why? All right. Anyways, so yeah. Okay. So there are a few horses here. The regular horses.
Oh, we have Tylenol riding a horse. Be like.
Renting a horse costs about 60 silver pieces per day, but owning a horse will cost you about 500 silver pieces. So more than a healing potion. And also the stallion costs
I'm gonna tell him that I'm gonna give him 120 for it, and if he doesn't like that offer, he's gonna have to suck it up.
I'm going to slap.
He could just not sell you the horse. No, he could just not sell you the horse.
Well, this is what he's trying to scrutinize here. It's fine. Wait, scrutinize. He's trying to
casually committing grand theft horsey.
He says he wants your stallion. I want your stallion. Give it. All right. He's like, I'm a big fan of you guys already. Except you, fuck. So here's the deal, mister. This guy's got an axe, and this girl's got titties. And I have a knife. I want your stallion, give it. So the guy is like looking at this boy with an axe, looking at this guy with a knife. And looking at this girl with the titties, and he's like, "That'll be 500 silver pieces, or 1,000 for the stallion." To buy horse. If you want to rent it, it's 60 for the horse, 120 for the stallion.
So he only has two horses.
No, he does. He has more regular horses, but he has one stallion.
All right, we could save money by having Tylenol and MODOK double up on a horse.
Just show us your more standard, less expensive horses.
These are all we got, man. Horses are much more.
He did tell us about our less expensive horses. They're the ones that are 500 silver.
I'll give him 250 for one.
If you,
how about I do the buying? All right.
It's
so
it's not in my character sheet, but I have experience when I lived up in the mountains.
I have a hard time believing that, sir, because horses
Horses
are mostly migrate. Horses mostly migrate towards the south. These horses, they're not easy to come by in this part of the world. Unless you're in D-Kicks. What the frick? I love this. Anyhow,
so I will do the buying because I am holding the money.
All right. And how much money do got?
Should be an inventory. I've got a running tab of.
All right, you have 2 PP, 248 GP, 181 SP, and 2,900 copper, or about 3,000 copper. Also a 40 GP diamond.
How
And how much silver is a GP worth again?
10.
10 silver, so that's...
And keep in mind, you got 5 people here. You also have a 40 GP diamond that you can sell to someone.
That's a lot of money for a Hans.
Do we have any monkey meat left over?
No, we ate it all.
It's been 3 days, man. Even if you didn't, it's rotting at this point.
Oh, I was gonna sell it to a butcher or something. If it wasn't rotting.
We already butchered it.
Yeah, he'd be able to sell it.
Why would you want to buy monkey meat, though?
So let's count up your total provisions in units.
We need to get,
so 29...
extra money.
Okay, I'm going to pull up my calculator here.
We do have a lot of cash, but I do not wish to blow it all on Hanses. So, let's see. We have 5 peoples. We can double up some peoples. 3 Hanses.
Or someone could just walk. We could take turns walking.
We or don't does this man,
that would be
this
slow.
Man have a smaller horse?
Does this
man have like a large pony or a smaller horse?
It's a large stallion, so it's like twice as big as the other horses.
Yeah,
there's only
but
one.
Does
stallion.
He have a smaller horse in his stables? Does
no,
he
they're,
have a
they're relatively
does. They're
no, apart,
the non-stallion horses.
Apart
they
from
are
the
500 silver,
like a smaller than average horse.
No, they're all relatively
told
the same
us
size.
Inventory. He doesn't have a small.
They're relatively the same size.
I didn't regular do that size part because it probably got cut out.
It was stated several times.
They're all relatively the same size apart from the stallion.
Alright.
Alright, I will do negotiating, so...
Okay, so in total, counting all of your provisions, you have 41,606 copper. Which equates to about 4,100 silver pieces. If you got one
yes,
horse...
I say we take 3...
What?
I say we take 3 regular haunts.
Okay.
And... We'll have some people double up.
Horny. Okay.
We'll let, whatever his name is, Myrtle, and, Tylenol double up.
Horny.
Yes.
And then we'll work it out from there.
Okay.
And then you and Vicaroos can double up.
Why do I have to double with Vicaroos?
Because he's a soft, squishy boy, and he needs someone to protect him.
Why can't you protect him? You were literally just bragging about it, how you keep everybody alive.
No, I'm the one that keeps them alive. That is, keeps them from dying. You're the one that hits things.
Well, I can't hit things if someone else is on the horse right behind me.
We'll swap.
Look, we'll buy 2 horses.
That's what I thought.
Take turns swapping with someone who's walking.
Oh, goodness gracious.
No. So we spent about... Did we buy the stallion?
No.
Okay. Then we spent about...
Unless you really want your own haunts, and we can spend 500 more silver.
Well, I mean, if you're willing to do that, then sure.
Let's return.
But...
What the heck?
Alright, so we buy 4 haunts. That's 2,000 silver.
Then we can sell them if we have to. For, probably like double the price or something.
Okay, so
Pod's meat.
Okay, so for three horses, not non-stallion horses, it'll cost you 1,500 silver, which will.
Didn't we just buy another one?
Yeah, we did just buy four Hanses now.
Oh, okay, so you're buying 20.
So you that's
I mean,
yes, because four. Because Taurus here didn't want to double up with Vacaroos, so
that's an expensive argument. But someone will have to double up with somebody.
It's more carry capacity for inventory space. Now, we'll be able to carry more monkey meat.
Here's the real question, Jared: which one is going to be in the front, and which one is going to be in the back? Better question is, who's stronger, you or Myrtle?
Tylenol's got like a +2 in strength.
What are his stats?
Which, is... Okay, so it's relatively likely that you are physically stronger than this man, so... You could probably be on top. I mean, in the front! In the front!
I'll just take that out of the GP. We'll pay him with gold.
Alrighty.
Should actually just destroy him.
Okay. Alrighty.
I put them in our allies tab.
Four haunts. Okay. Okay. So now you guys, are brought around to the, son of a bitch. Okay, so now you guys are brought to the, turtle. So now you guys are brought around to the, stable with all the horses. You get that horsey smell, some of you guys are, more a fan of than others. Myrtle's like, oh god, manure! I hate manure! And then, he opens the thing, brings out four of them, and is like, don't go murdering people, please, just pay the right price if you have it. He's looking mostly at you, Taurus. She shot that out of her hair! Anyways, Alright. Next, let's move on. And you guys bring up, you guys get onto your horses, and Myrtle goes on like, are you gonna be up front, or am I? It's looking at you, Tylenol.
I'll be in the back. And then we'll switch later.
Alright. Are we gonna do this double dash style, where you're kind of just, like, hopping? Where you're just... You know Mario Kart double dash, where, there's two...
Yeah, I know. Hold up. Those of you that are unaware, this is the reference.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, they're not doing it there, but usually... But when you, press the Z button, the two cart drivers kind of just switch. Like one hops to the front seat as the other one hops to the back seat.
I thought we were going to be doing, like, a sick drift on the horse. Double dash.
Just, like, plug the mushroom into the back of the horse, and the horse's eyes go wide and just speeds forward as you drift.
Oh, man.
Alright, anyways, though. Now you guys are... are traveling by horse, and your destination is, well, through this war-torn hellscape. Well, that's copyright because there's an actual continent in this world named Hell. So, I guess that is, I don't know. The name is, I keep forgetting my own, the landmarks of my own made-up places. Locations, Ohio, Olora, Poop, Grand Empire of Monzoa. Okay, you guys are now beginning to travel through the Great Empire of Monzoa. Since horses can't... since the walking speed of a horse is... can be about twice as fast as a human, or about six as fast when running, you can make it across the country relatively a lot faster. Obviously, it'll still take a couple days, though. Goodness gracious, now what? Oh, it's a little turtle! Okay.
It do be. Alright, we go twice fast now.
Thank you, Mom. Okay. Yep. Okay, so...
I like this Hans. I shall name him Boo.
Right, so for a normal travel pace would be about 25 miles per day, but this is up to about 50. Or if you want the horse to move faster, it can go clear up to about 150 miles in a day.
Well, we can't run the horses too much because that kills them.
That do be true. Okay. Alright, so now you guys are, so are you guys traveling at that aforementioned normal pace? That is twice?
Normal pace.
Okay.
Yeah, pretty much.
Or if you're particularly brave, you could go thrice. So now you begin traveling through the... through the country of Monzoa, and it's relatively windy. Feels nice. Some are wildernesses, others are, you know, barren wastelands. You come across a lot of ruins. Relatively depressing, but eventually, towards the end of the day, you come across a town.
Okay.
The name of the town? Oh, PayPal me $30. Aw. Okay. The name of the town is Bell.
Bell.
Okay. So, so at this point, it's getting, the sun is starting to set a little bit. Say it's 6:02. And you notice that there's a bunch of people excitedly going up to you and saying, "Visitors! Whoa, visitors! We love visitors, all of us. Man, look at that! Look at those people. They're all so diverse. They're on horses. Guys, we've got cowboys and cowgirls here. Come on, guys! Look, we got visitors. We never get visitors."
Somebody shoot them.
What did that guy say? I don't know, but I love them. Come on, let us show you around the beautiful village of Bell. Come on, get off your horses. We've got places to dock your horses. We'll take good care of them. We'll take good care of you too. Everything's gonna be A-okay. Are you guys virgins?
Sorry, I'm not from Virginia. I'm from Ohio.
That is the name of the continent, funny enough.
It is indeed.
It's not important. It's not important. We'll show you around. We'll find out eventually about the answer. But anyways, though, come on. We'll show you around here. It's beautiful. You'll love the sunset. You'll love everything. If you like romantic scenery, you got it. If you like beautiful, delicious cuisines, we got that here in Bell. Come on. So they borderline drag you off your horses and tie the horses together.
In a whisper to whichever one of my party members is closest to me.
Taurus.
Okay. I'm very uncomfortable right now.
So am I. I'm saying.
He's whispering that to Taurus, so you probably don't hear him.
Oh, yeah. Well, I'm going to do the whisper thing, too, because I was about to anyways. Yeah. Like, yeah, this is...
He's way too eager.
Pedo land.
Alright. Greetings, fellow travelers. I am the mayor of this fine village. My name is... No! Not her!
No, come.
Sus time.
My name is Zane. I am the mayor of Bell. How are you fine travelers today? Guys,
I am fine, I suppose.
Hello, Mayor Zane. Chill. I have come to the conclusion that all five of these, except for Tylenol, are all virgins.
Tylenol, were you doing something else besides eating the cat that we should know about?
I'm sorry, what warranted this?
Oh, it's not important, I promise you. None of this...
Is it
none
some
of that
magic
is
spell or something?
We're just really observant. We love to know all about our visitors. We rarely get visitors. We're just eager, I'm sorry. Is it wrong?
I lean over to the nearest one and I'm like, I wonder why.
I mean, is it wrong for people to be vegan? Ear, I'm sorry. I don't know. Suddenly...
His cock out.
Suddenly, they're kind of like, come on. You're Tylenol, right? Come on. Come on over here. So Tylenol is automatically, and all of you are getting red flags from that automatically, because you did not mention your names at all. So there.
Yeah, we did not mention those.
So come on, Tylenol. We're gonna have a good time. You gotta check out the sunset. Now Myrtle is like, whoa, what's going on? What are you doing? Tylenol, just you gotta make a safe word here.
You gotta Tylenol. I can do something, Tylenol.
Right. At that exact moment, handcuffs are put onto the other four of you. It's like, hey, what's the meaning of this? Hey, stop that. Hey, that's my butt.
How'd they get close enough to touch me?
They were very,
you know that
much
thing
close enough.
You ever heard of Dragon Ball Z?
where they just teleport behind you and go.
So, Vicaruz, Tylenol, Vicaruz, Taris, Bruno, and I keep forgetting his name, Myrtle, you all have handcuffs on you. Tylenol, you do not have a handcuff on you, but you are kind of being led astray from the group, and,
What is the meaning of this?
It's not important. Don't worry about it. We may be eager, but we're not stupid, okay? Come on. We'll show you to our true leader.
He's trying to freak me.
No, you're too young. We're not gonna do any of that. That's disgusting.
Professionals have standards.
I don't know. The first question was, are you virgins? So I question your intentions here.
Okay, that's fair, but, he has his handcuffs on, right? Yep, all of them have their handcuffs on, except the lady. She's being led astray as normal. Okay, that's fine. You're all about to be, eaten.
Oh, lovely.
End of episode.
Alive?
Yep.
Oh, that was a horrible place to leave it off.
I mean, you did ask.
Wait, how?
Jared, you did ask me
how
for more spontaneity.
How strong are the handcuffs?
What?
Did ask
how strong
what?
Are the handcuffs?
Well, you'll have to test that out in the next episode of Lunar. Although that, I'm.
What was I trying to tell you?
I think it is fair to. What?
What was it you were trying to tell me, or I was trying to tell you, or something?
You did ask me for spontaneity.
Spontaneity. Oh, yes.
And what?
Yeah,
so,
that is true.
This is actually a story arc that I've been planning out ever since the beginning of this. So you know.
All right. So.
So I thought, you know what? If you want spontaneity, it's going to be now. You're gonna get bored.
Quick question. quick question. How many spells can I have prepared at once?
Should be your wisdom modifier plus your cleric level. So 5, I think.
All right, my sheet only has 4 prepared.
Oh right, I probably should have asked you along with them. You can do that now since the episode ended, but Tylenol, no, you are not going to get Vord because you are not a virgin.
I.
Oh, and the.
Only the unvirgins get eaten away.
Tylenol does not know this. They're not telling you this, but that I'm telling you now. Okay, Bruno.
Yeah, the fifth one I'm preparing is command.
Okay. Keep in mind that is all in preparation for something you are not aware of is going to happen to you for the day. So.
Well, I'd very much like to not be in these handcuffs anymore, so.
I know, but you didn't.
I don't know that I'm getting beat, but I also.
But keep in mind that you would have been preparing these spells before you even arrived in this town, so you would not have.
My other option for preparing a spell on my prepared spell list is Shield of Faith.
I frankly prefer
Command.
In that case, I have a thought, and I don't have to worry about preparing something I didn't prepare. I have Mage Hand. I bet I could use that to try to steal a key and get us unlocked.
You could.
Right. Oh, and to answer your question, Taris.
I'm going to try to break the handcuffs.
Right.
We also have a rogue.
To answer your question, Taris, I think it's fair to say that as soon as you realized you were in handcuffs, I think it's fair to say that Taris would have probably tried to break them as soon as he could, but he could not.
man is a mole. Do you know how jacked I am and how much I poured into strength?
It's metal.
Would have been a great...
Yeah, but still, do you know how much I poured into strength?
You know what would have been fantastic to have at this moment?
You've got a +3 in strength.
A gag character from Dragon Ball to break you out of these handcuffs. You know what Dragon Ball characters are known for doing? Breaking out of handcuffs.
Well, what the balls was that for?
How are we going to get out of these handcuffs? You ever heard of Dragon Balls?
Alright, I'm going to stop the recording.